Humans have the ability to eat and digest both animal and plant foods. In other words, animal foods are a part of the natural diet for people. When animal proteins are eaten and digested, they pass into the blood as amino acids. Amino acids are not an energy source. Amino acids play an important role in cell structure, formation of our tissues and bones. In addition, they play a role in the structure of many hormones and enzymes and in many biochemical activities. There are about 20 different types of amino acids. However, 9 of them are essential amino acids, so these 9 amino acids must be taken from food. In addition to being a source of protein, animal foods also contain other very important elements for our health and metabolism. They contain the B vitamins, iron, zinc, and selenium. Animal proteins are very important in childhood and adolescence. After a certain age, that is, after the end of growth and development, our need for animal proteins decreases considerably. So, how much protein should we consume? It is recommended to consume 0.8 grams of protein per kilogram for adults. According to this, a person weighing 60 kilograms should consume an average of 48 grams of protein per day. Well, if meat is part of our natural diet, then why is there a debate about whether meat is healthy or unhealthy? There are serious damages in excessive protein consumption. We know that the excess carbohydrates we get from foods are stored by the liver as glycogen and fat. This situation leads to obesity and diabetes over time. So what happens to the excess amino acids that result from protein digestion? Since surplus amino acids cannot be used as an energy source and cannot be stored at the same time, they turn into ketone bodies and urea. During this conversion, uric acid occurs and, as is known, uric acid is the only cause of gout. In addition, uric acid forms a basis for hypertension, diabetes, and cardiovascular diseases. In summary, eating the right amount of meat is healthy, but excessive meat consumption can cause serious illnesses. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our YouTube channel.